Next topic is angle between two planes. Now I have already drawn a figure here. One plane is in red and one plane is in blue. Now what the angle between them is, let's define it first. Now the angle between two planes is defined as the angle between their normals. So this is just a simple definition for the angle between two planes. Now let's write it in the vector form and then in the Cartesian form. Now first of all, vector form. Vector form. First thing is, now let theta be the angle, let theta be the angle between the planes vector r dot n1 is equal to d1 and vector r dot vector n2 is equal to d2, then cos theta is equal to vector n1 dot vector n2 upon magnitude of vector n1 magnitude of vector n2. So this is in the vector form. Now let's prove it. Proof. Now if, now here I have drawn angle between the two planes, this is theta and these are the two normals, okay, normal to plane 1, normal to plane 2, like this one, okay. So this is theta, angle between the planes from blue to red, and from one normal to the second normal, this is also theta, okay. So if theta is the angle between the planes, then theta is also angle between their normals, say vector n1 and vector n2, okay. Therefore vector n1 dot vector n2 is equal to magnitude of n1 magnitude of n2 with cos theta, okay. Or cos theta is equal to vector n1 dot vector n2 upon magnitude of vector n1 magnitude of vector n2. So this is first very simple thing. Now conditions. Now number one condition for perpendicularity, condition for perpendicularity. Now if planes vector r dot vector n1 is equal to d1 and vector r dot vector n2 is equal to d2 are perpendicular then vector n1 and vector n2 these are their normals are also perpendicular. Therefore, vector n1 dot vector n2 is equal to 0. Condition for the perpendicularity. Now, number 2. Condition for parallelism. Okay, second condition. Now, here if planes vector r dot vector n1 is equal to d1 and vector r dot vector n2 is equal to d2 are parallel, then their normals is also parallel to vector n2. Then there exists a scalar lambda, then there exists a scalar lambda such that vector n1 is equal to lambda vector n2. So this is the second condition. So these are the two conditions. This is a angle between the two planes in the vector form, and condition of perpendicularity and condition of parallelism.